Moving on to, here's other stuff that came out this week. DC had Batman Black and White number one. It's a $5 great book with great creators. You got Chip Kidd on here. You got Neil Adams. You got Sean Murphy on art. You got Joe Quinones. You got Chris Samnee. It's just really great. Single one and done little snippets of stories of iconic Batman stuff that I freaking loved. If you love Batman, this is not New 52. This is more iconic, like animated series, like that type of stuff that I loved it. Check it out. And Master of the Universe DC versus, this is just fun. This is just, it's the same dude, Giffen, that's writing the Master of the Universe. And here's one thing I'll say about it. The link between the two worlds is John Constantine. The character that has been like Alan Moore and Vertigo and just totally off the grid, totally in his own universe that had no superheroes and certainly no, like, you know, masters of the universe. And he is the connecting piece. And I liked it. It's fun. I dug it. Here's the indie stuff. Hoax Hunters restarted. It's not a new number one. It's actually number 10, but it's the season two. And kind of cool to say seasons because it did get picked up and optioned to be a TV show. And it's basically these hoax hunters, they go out to where supernatural stuff has happened and they cover it up. And that's pretty cool. I got Fandom variants, and the first four Fandom variants all connect to make a big portrait. And the art in here, dude named T-Rex, I haven't seen him before, and I loved it. I loved his art. Very, very moody. If you've never checked out Hoax Hunter, just pick up this issue 10 and flip through it. If it catches your fancy, get it. I enjoyed it. Quantum and Woody, I'm loving this book. The first issue was good. Second issue, a lot more of their signature humor. Really dug it. And this one, there was blackface. So, you know, I'm totally sold when it comes to blackface. And James Asmus is kicking some butt. This is very funny. I laughed out loud throughout. I loved it. Trillium, Jeff Lemire, issue 2, just as good as issue 1. You remember that book that had where you flip the front cover, back cover, and they met in the middle. Here they're together, and the Trillium is what holds them together, what can have them be able to even converse with each other. And I'm really digging this sci-fi romance, time travel craziness. And Jeff Lemire, I like this book a lot. He's good. That's just a pinnacle of his work, writing and drawing. Moving on, Avatar and Hickman, not two things that have gone together before. He's usually an Image guy or Marvel guy, and this is God is Dead, and it's the Avatar feel of just lots of chaos, lots of carnage, lots of death, lots of nudity, and it definitely delivers for those Avatar type of tropes. As far as Hickman, it's lots of mythology, and it's gods from different mythologies all together, back on a current Earth and ready to reclaim it as their own, and it was definitely fun, definitely worth checking out, definitely like his Image stuff. It's just, he's at Avatar with this, and if you like his Image stuff, get it. You know, it might be your first Avatar book you ever bought, and maybe that's what Avatar was thinking when they got him on there, but I truly enjoyed it. And finally, The Star Wars. No, I'm not being weird. It's called The Star Wars, and it is based on George Lucas's original draft of his original screenplay where he wrote himself as a protagonist. I mean, seriously, look at this General Skywalker. It looks like him. He's got the gray hair and the beard and everything, and it's cool. It's cool, like, kind of a through-the-looking-glass alternate reality, what could have been. It, nothing that we know from our Star Wars spoils anything. I mean, this is so different. There's some Star Killer. It's it was enjoyable. I really dug it. So if you're a lifelong Star Wars fan and you want to have something in the Star Wars universe but alt universe and have Lucas's original draft in a comic form, which, you know, it's most likely never gonna be made into a movie or a cartoon or anything, get it. I thoroughly enjoyed it, even though, you know, it's essentially George Lucas as the protagonist, but you gotta give him that. I mean, he didn't make it into the movie eventually, so he made the right choice, and we get a good comic book, you know, years and years later, decades later. Moving on to Marvel, finally, Infinity number 2 is out. Infinity is their big deal crossover by Hickman, who is also doing this, God is Dead, and I'm digging it. I like that it's on time. They're switching between artists, and they're all artists that Hickman likes working with, like Opina and Weaver, and I like how much everything is stacked against them. I like all of the destruction. I like that while the Avengers are failing off-world, the heroes back on Earth are also failing. And just all this, it's kind of a tinge of Forever Evil here that evil is winning, the heroes are gone off-world, and it just seems like they always kind of overlap themes, but I certainly dug it. I've already read beyond this checklist on the Marvel retailer site, and I'm loving how it's all coming together and how the Avengers, New Avengers, enrich it between the parts because it's all written by Hickman and it has room to breathe, and there's so much action in these issues, and then there's the breathing room and the connectivity in the New Avengers and Avengers, and this is just how to do a crossover. It's much like Blackest Night with Geoff Johns, and I'm probably going to mention that every time. Moving on to Superior Spider-Man, this is what everyone has been wanting, what everyone thought was going to happen with when, you know, it was awk as Spider-Man. Everyone thought it was going to be 2099. And Spider-Man, Miguel O'Hara from 2099 Spider-Man is here. He is here this issue. I promise you, it's not a bait and switch. It does deliver. They do meet face-to-face this issue. It is awesome. And for all the naysayers that didn't want awk Spidey or want Peter, whatever, if this is what it took to get 2099 Spider-Man back and in our time and interacting with the universe, cool, awesome, great. I super enjoyed it. Dan Slott has had my attention this whole run, and now here with issue 17, he just added so much fuel to the fire, and I freaking loved it. And Stegman is kicking so much ass on the art, and I like seeing Stegman do 2099. It was really cool, and I think anyone that was a 2099 fan is going to enjoy it, because it's obvious that Dan Slott was. Going back to villains, foes, all that stuff, evil, Superior Foes of Spider-Man 3's out. I'd be remiss not to mention it. It's by my friend Nick Spencer, and I laughed so many times at the dark humor throughout. This book is just unique in Marvel's wheelhouse. I loved it. It's not Thunderbolts. It is its own unique thing, and Thunderbolts-ish things and ish characters are in here, and you see the difference, and it's so fun. And then finally, I know, huge week, but Battle of the Atom started. It's the big deal, 50th anniversary X-Men story arc. The first two parts are both out this week. This one is part one. It's by Bendis and Frank Cho on art. And, you know, we've had the X-Men from the past, the original X-Men in our time. Then some X-Men from the future come back to our time. And then it's three casts of X-Men, all kinds of craziness, days of futures, past, future, in the past, and I loved it. I love Frank Cho's art. I've just been, Bendis has been so re-energized in the mutant universe, and I'm thoroughly enjoying it. And All New X-Men also came out, you know, by Bendis that focused on the young kids, and you have a Marvel Girl and Cyclops, and it's just, it's a crazy time travel nutty X-Men sci-fi superhero romp that we love and that I think Bendis is going to do very well. And of course, we'll have some help from Jason Aaron. Thanks, guys. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching both part one and two if you did. Click subscribe, comment on it, check out our Facebook. And if you're local, you know what to do. We have the Geekeasy. We got beer. We got trivia on Tuesday nights. We're open till midnight on Friday and Saturday, and we're having fun. And we have a big announcement for the Geekeasy that includes me specifically starting next week. Thanks. Bye-bye.